Now, start. Mr. Deputy Chairman, Sir, our beloved President, in his address to members of Parliament on 17th February, has given a very comprehensive and realistic picture of India and India's relations with the outside world. It is a matter of gratification, indeed, that we have started coming out of the economic stagnation which bewildered the nation for the last couple of years. More than 70% of the people are engaged in agriculture. Nearly 50% of our income comes from agriculture. That being so, it is but natural that we have to concentrate on agriculture and make conscious efforts to increase our output. Our agricultural production has more than doubled in the last two decades, from a total production of 50 million tons when we achieved independence. Food grain production has gone up to 1,000 million tons. In spite of many scientific and technological developments, agriculture still has to depend to a large extent on the monsoons. No scientific method has yet been evolved to control rains, but efforts at rain making should continue. Even so, India had faced a cycle of adverse monsoons over the last few years. As a result, production in 2002-03 went down to 900 million tons. There was unprecedented and widespread drought conditions throughout a major part of India. In the face of these adverse conditions, we have braved the difficulties with courage and fortitude. During 2003-04, the total rice production stood at around 300 million tons. This is not an insignificant achievement. Other cash crops like jute, cotton, and sugarcane had also shown significant improvement. India is likely to have a total jute crop of 150 lakh tons. Cotton production will touch an all-time record of nearly 200 lakh bales. Sugar output is put at 300 lakh tons, out of which 100 lakh tons is exported. These are significant pointers to a meaningful policy being followed by the government. Thanks to the realization and understanding of the public distribution system, India has been able to look after the minimum needs of the most vulnerable sections. The public distribution system needs nearly 10 million tons of food grains annually. The government is confident of meeting this obligation without much difficulty. Plans for investments in irrigation projects, fertilizers, plants, and hydel projects should be pushed on war footing. Many irrigation projects are pending clearance from the center because of river water dispute they are existing between the states. Recently, a shiver lining was seen in the sky with the three chief ministers of Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, and Kerala agreeing in principle to constitute the Cauvery River Valley Authority to settle the allocation of water for cash state. Unfortunately, it has not borne fruit. I would again use the ministers for agriculture and irrigation to request the chief ministers again to sit at the table and agree to constitute the Kaveri River Valley Authority so that these disputes can be solved. Once and for all, there are similar river water disputes in other areas. For example, with regard to sharing of Narmada waters, there is a dispute between Gujarat and Madhya Pradesh. I would urge that all these river water disputes should be frozen and river valley authorities should be set up once and for all to settle the allocation of water and also to go ahead with the construction of irrigation projects. Coming to industry, sir, we all know that the growth rate of industry was almost zero in 2003-04. Thanks to progressive policy and vigorous implementation of those policies, the growth rate now is 3.5%. With regard to ensure fuller utilization of capacity and assurance to supply scarce industrial raw materials at international prices, it is possible that the current year may turn out a better picture for industry. The kingpin of industrial growth lies in coal, steel, and power. Coal production, which was 80 million tons last year, has improved to 90 million tons by now. There is no longer any shortage of steel. Thermal power has gone up by 14%, and hydel power in DVC has already been stated by the president has gone up by 34%. There is still power shortage in many states of India, particularly in Tamil Nadu and to some extent in Karnataka, Haryana and Punjab. So the power project should be given top priority, and the power project of Kalindi, for which the foundation was laid by our beloved Prime Minister, should be taken up with speed and completed as early as possible. Mr. Deputy Chairman, sir, you are aware that we had to spend more for import of oil because of the rise in prices of oil. It is encouraging to find that we have struck off shore in Bombay High, and it is expected that we will be able to produce 100 million tons of oil from Bombay High.